Hey, Lisa the Love Coach here, and today on Lisa's Lowdown on Love, I am talking to you about cheating. Why do people cheat? It's really, really important that you have some understanding. If you're looking and searching for answers and it led you to this video, I feel you, I'm with you, I've been there, I've been cheated on, I've cheated. I'm gonna give you the whole breakdown on what goes on in the mind that is making people do these things to each other. So I'm hopeful this video serves you well. Let me jump on in by saying, if you were cheated on, please understand that it has nothing to do with you. It has nothing to do with you. It is not your fault. You are not doing anything or not doing anything or doing too much of something or being a certain way that is making the other person cheat. So let's just please, please, please be very clear on that. And I'm gonna give you the real deal as to what's going on. When a person loves themselves, they don't cheat. They tend to thrive in their relationships, and even when the relationship is ending and they wanna exit the relationship, they are sure to do it in a dignified way. Now, a lot of people watching this might be in marriages and not just dating, and so when the cheating happens in a marriage, it becomes a whole different ballgame. Sometimes people who are part of infidelity and are victim, if you want to use that word, of infidelity and their spouse is cheating on them, remain in the relationship because obviously you made a vow, you made a commitment, you made promises that you were going to work something out with somebody through thick and thin. So here's the thing with that. A lot of times we choose to stay in relationships because we want to work something out, but we don't know how to do it. So back in the day, I cheated on my husband, and I assure you, the reason why I did it had nothing to do with something that was up in my marriage. I may have thought so, but deep, deep down, it had to do with the lack of self-love that I had for me. Because if I had an issue in my relationship, I could have very easily sat my husband down and say, listen, I am feeling this way. And I'm suffering inside, and I don't know what's wrong with me, and I don't know what's going on, and I just really need your help, and I feel lost and confused, and I don't know what's going on. And any spouse would want to come to help you. Anybody in a healthy relationship would come together and be like, what do we need to do? Do we need to go to therapy? Do we need to hire a coach? So the reason why I do what I do for people as a certified professional love life coach is because I know that based on the wisdom that I have, the cheating that I did, and then the revenge cheating that happened when my husband cheated on me, and this whole entire chaotic thing that spiraled out of control and ended up in divorce years and years and years later, I want people to sidestep the minefields that you come across in your relationships so that you can handle the problems before they blow up so big that there's no turning back. So understand, if you're seeing this video and you were cheated on, the person who cheated on you is cheating on you because they don't have love for themselves. And listen, they might be coming at you super narcissistic, they might be tormenting you, they might be bullying you. It's all because they don't love themselves. Now here's the problem for you. If you choose to stick around with someone who doesn't love themselves, then you have to commit to getting them the help that they need. And what happens is sometimes when you're dealing with super narcissistic personalities, they don't think that they're the problem. They will blame you and make you feel like you're the problem when that is not exactly the case. It's crazy making. Because they will take your self-esteem and they will mush it to the ground and stomp on it and make you feel horrible. You will cry, you will feel alone, it will be terrible and a nightmare for you. And really what you want to do is exit that relationship, because those types of people do not even want the help, they don't think they're doing anything wrong, and they have no remorse. They don't think that they are even at fault. They may even go as far as to justify why they cheated on you. And they know that if you are dependent upon them for money or for a lifestyle, that they kind of have control over you, and they will exploit that. They will use that to your disadvantage, and they'll talk to you in a way that makes you feel so afraid to stick up for yourself and to find your own peace. So there are different levels of cheating, right? There are different levels of relationships and how cheating affects and impacts that relationship. In my situation, I was married and I felt that there was something missing within myself, and I chose to look outside of the relationship, outside of my marriage, for whatever that was. And even outside of me, I was completely disconnected to myself. So it wasn't only until I did the work on me after my divorce, after that real big time healing process, was when I realized all the reasons why I did everything that I did in all of my relationships, not just my marriage. There were patterns that I saw, and what they were all rooted in was a lack of self-love, not feeling like I had a voice, not feeling like my opinions even mattered, and a slew of other things that I was able to uncover through this kind of work that I now offer for people. And once I came out the other side of this, I realized that I was codependent. I realized that I also had narcissistic traits. I realized that there was a whole other way to be in a relationship, and what my parents taught me, what I observed in my family, my extended family, even the people who I was left with for care. I just got a bunch of different programming that was not serving me well in my life, and I had to get to the bottom of that. And I had to really parent myself all over again and step up for myself in a loving way, so that all of the things that led me to look outside of myself for happiness, for soothing, for nourishment, for emotional grounding, I was able to provide that for myself. And once I learned how to do that, my entire life changed. I started to do a whole different profession, helping other people, and I started to also appear differently in my relationships. I'm happy to report I'm in a relationship now. Number one relationship with me, but yes, I am in a relationship, a happy, healthy, beautiful, nice relationship. And the thing is, I am super transparent, and I'm easygoing and chill, and it's just a very different relationship altogether. But it really starts with your own healing. It doesn't start with looking outside. In fact, the relationship that I am in now, I probably would not be able to have been in that relationship before. I probably would not have even attracted the man that I'm with now because of how I was and the energy that I was bringing to my dating experiences and my relationships. So I encourage you to click on the link below. You can find me at lovequestcoaching.com. That's lovequestcoaching.com. And when you get there, there will be a link where you could click the button and do a love life assessment. And that will give you the opportunity to tell me what's going on in your relationship. If you've been cheated on or cheated or thinking of cheating, there's something deeper going on with you. And I can absolutely help you sort that out, because I did it for myself. And woo girl, if I can do it, anybody can do it. It takes a lot of love for yourself and just the will to know that there's a better way. So I'm hopeful that I help you out and that we connect soon. Thanks so much. Bye.